Right, AfriForum Margaret has been asked by the community, the local community, to get involved with the illegal tapping of electricity in the Masinenge, Yuvanga area. And our friend here from Wolf Security, Jaco Jansen van Vieren, he's also very tirelessly involved with the fact that the electricity is being stolen and there's some people electrocuted. There was incident reports, but there's no cases that were made at the SAPS. The problem with electricity theft is that in the Act of 86, has been amended in 2006, making it not a criminal offence to steal electricity because it's not something that you can touch. That becomes a very touchy subject then, as to which SAPS and the Eskom doesn't want to get too involved with. And the problem with that is that we base it on the Health and Safety Act that we have to call upon and to make this thing to be able to escalate and to be able to prosecute on those bases. But as you guys can see, how much of wire we've already pulled is, this is already the third load of wire that has been pulled, and we're still on its way to maybe do another 60%. We've only touched barely 30% of the total wires that's been stripped from the area. I'm talking fence lines, telecom wires, Eskom wires, doringdraad, as I shall say, and even thin core wires. You can't believe what these guys put towards their houses and the jeopardy they place their own people in retrospect to be able to get electricity. We want to know from local government, Eskom, what are they going to do about it? Because this is becoming a health hazard to the whole community, not just the businesses in this area, but also to the community at large. That is the responsibility of local government. Another thing that AfriForum would like to state is the fact that the health and security of this local population here and this camp here is seriously jeopardized. And who do you keep responsible but council for that? Council it's council's land. Council is supposed to make sure. Council is supposed to make sure that these guys are living in decent conditions and that health and safety is a priority. Because toddlers are wandering there, unbeknown to them, they step on a live wire which is not properly earthed and not properly covered, and there you have another fatality in the community. But he wouldn't listen to you. Because when you get in your pocket cars, you're right. Basically, this wiring is quite ingenious how they tap these electricity. It gets tapped from the electricity boxes, it gets tapped from telephone wires, it gets tapped from people's electricity boxes in their yard. And the people are scared to report these things because the problem is they get threatened and said if they disconnect it, then the people will come and burn down the businesses. So the threat is real, the problem is real. These guys are losing, because they're running three-phase power, for instance, here, they're losing some phases, in which case their crushers and their pumps and things pack up because it's not enough voltage to power those things. And these guys are running huge losses in repairing those things. And also as a result of that, the Eskom account has escalated from the average 6,000 rand a month to 12,000 rand a month. And that's the problem that these guys have to endure. The ingenious part of this whole exercise and how these guys are so clever is to take it right underneath the highway through the drains, the water drains. How they actually dig up a part of the tar road and hide it nice and neatly, right, and then cover it again. You don't even notice it. That's how ingenious these guys go to work.